Oh, Lord. They saying, Faith, can you talk about Stassi and LVP racism? Ooh, Lord. Girl,
that's that about?
Girl. You know, I did a show with the all-white cast. After...
You were the only black person.
The only black person on the show. Girl. Yes, only... Yes. I know. And it was... Girl, it was a lot. It was Bravo. So the audience there is different than like the MTV audience. And it was I felt like after their friend did something that we both were involved in that he's done like 1,000 times, for some reason they wanted to attack me instead of him. It was like they wanted to attack. Like, you know, I was wrong and I was this and I was that, calling me names, saying my hair was nappy, which was weird coming out of their mouths, and like. And I believe it hit the ceiling for me and made me really want to run for the hills when Kristen and Stassi decided they were going to call the cops on me. This is when I quit. Like, I left the show, I was invited back, but, you know, to tell my truth, but decided it wasn't going to do anything for me. So I ended up not coming back. So I decided to go over MTV. Once I did that, I felt like they got upset with me because I was at a club called Lucy Bellows. There's a guy who partially owns that club named Marcus Molinari, who's amazing. And I seen them, Kristen and Stassi there. I think I seen Kristen there for sure though. And there was this article on Daily Mail.
Uh-huh.
It was an article out where there was an African American lady who it was like a weird photo, so she looked very, very light skinned. Had these different like weird tattoos or whatever, and they showcased her, and I guess this woman was like robbing people and stealing like gold bars. The woman was at large. Okay. She was drugging them. She was on a mission. And they called the cops and said it was me. Yes. And this is like true story. I heard this from actually Stassi doing an interview. She's telling them what they did to me. So they called the cops on me. The police say, oh, that sounds crazy. We're not coming. That's not Faith. We looked it up. That's not her. It was somebody else. But it was just funny because they thought it was me because it was a black woman with a weave. So they just assumed it would be me. And they called the cops on me. And it didn't work. So they were upset about that. Then that didn't work. So they said, oh, well, she's military. She's AWOL. The military is looking for her. So get her that way. No. I was actually honorable discharged, and I have that paperwork, and I showed that as well online. And I was upset that they were trying every avenue, and really upset that MTV decided to kind of bring me on there. So, yeah, that was really crazy because I wasn't on a season with Kristen or Stassi like that. So I didn't know them like that. I didn't hang out with them, that they was using their platform to attack.
So.
Instead of the person that they were friends with. It was like they were really trying their best to come my way. I get people being upset, but I didn't understand why I was getting so much heat and the man wasn't, who's still filming and who's still doing what he normally does. I didn't understand that part. That was the only thing. And a part of me was like, you know, I can do the whole vengeance thing and go crazy. But I was so excited about my new opportunity with MTV that I just didn't really entertain them. Mm. So I guess I'll be getting a lot of messages lately because a lot of them now are screaming Black Lives Matter. And it's like, that's exactly what I know some of them, and I know they are definitely don't care about Black people like that. There's a few of them that do, but there's a lot of them that really don't give a damn. I've seen a lot. So it's pretty weird that they're screaming Black Lives Matter when they didn't even think it was.
That's cute. That's real.
Yeah.
Cute. Huh? Yeah, that's cute.
yeah, you're right. I won't give them what they want. You're right.